Okay, this is a patient who presented in multi-system failure. The patient was in very poor condition, but the patient presented with right upper extremity edema of uncertain etiology. And the patient of significance is the patient had a PICC line in that was recently discontinued. So this is an upper extremity venous examination. And the sonographer right now at this point is doing compression maneuvers. We have a dual screen, but the compression maneuvers of the brachial veins. And something in this clip, I'm going to let this play a couple more times, something in this clip caught the sonographer's eye. We'll see if it catches your eye. We'll let the clip play one more time. Okay, it went by really fast just a second ago. Did you see that? Okay, next slide, please. Now, in that last clip, this was just there for just a split second. The sonographer was sliding and compressing the brachial veins, but now that caught their eye. And so let's look a little more closely at this. So we're seeing... We're transverse, we're over the brachial artery, and then we're seeing what looks like pulsatile flow coming up here and then up to here. And this is very near the location of where the PICC line was inserted, almost to the level of the antecubital fossa. So what's going on here, I'll go ahead and spill the beans, is this patient has a brachial artery pseudoaneurysm, and no way to prove it, but what we're thinking happened here is when the puncture was made to introduce the PICC line, that there was a needle stick to the brachial artery itself, and then this pseudoaneurysm developed because of the puncture to the brachial artery during the PICC line insertion. So we have, it's not a very big pseudoaneurysm, and actually nothing was done about it. The patient had multi-system failure basically and succumbed a day or two after this examination. But the diagnosis here is right brachial artery pseudoaneurysm. So we're going to go ahead and look at a few more clips here from this case. Next slide, please. So here's another look. I'll stand off to the side here. And it looks like right about here is the neck of the pseudoaneurysm. So, and here's brachial artery. So kind of a serpentine track there, right there, is the neck of the pseudoaneurysm. Next slide, please. So again, here's the neck area, and the sonographer went ahead and measured the neck. 3.6 millimeters is the neck of the pseudoaneurysm. Next slide, please. And here's another look at the neck area. And the blood's flowing up into this little pocket here, that little pseudoaneurysmal pocket. Next slide, please. And this clip is showing the cephalic vein in the upper arm, and this is the vessel that the PICC line was in. And you can see that it's not fully compressing. And then at part of this clip, you can see its close proximity to the brachial artery. So brachial artery right there. So evidently when they were sticking that cephalic vein, or what probably was the antecubital vein which morphed into the cephalic vein, was right there where they were right next door to the brachial artery, and the puncture penetrated the brachial artery during the PICC line insertion. And we do have some thrombus within that cephalic vein there.